water. These people are fired up. I've had a number of emails back. They're saying thank you so much for coming down and sharing your story. So Site 41 continues to grow. Just so you know, you may not know, I've been fighting the development of a gravel pit in tiny township for many years, because other areas, you know, we've been fighting this dump, but other areas are fighting to save their water and developing the gravel pits. Well, where I live, in the Wyebridge upland region, which was the recharge zone for Site 41, and not just Site 41, all of us, it's where it cleans water. And we now know that that upland region does such a good job, it's created the cleanest, purest water in the world. So I have some concerns about all of these gravel pits going ahead. Sargent has bought in excess of 600 acres. If you go into Midland and you look at that pit, you think, well, how big is that pit that Beamish owns? Well, it's not 100 acres. This is big. And Beamish already has a pit behind my house that they just started mining. And I went to the OMB, I went through all this stuff and got quite nicely beat up because I wasn't allowed to use any of the evidence from Site 41 because I wasn't an expert.
Oh, God.
So, the water. They're going right in. They're going to mine that beautiful, pure water. And it's not going to have an effect. Isn't that amazing? It's not going to have an effect on anything. And I'm like, Gord Miller, the Environmental Commissioner of Ontario, really went out on a limb for us.
Yeah.
And said, look, there's something wrong up there.
Yeah.
And guess what? He came back out in the limb and he said, all of these gravel pits, we need to do a cumulative impact studies to find out what's it all happening when you open up all these holes. But nobody wants to listen to him. And fact is, Doug Jager, our favorite hydrogeologist, told the ministry they should consider making the upland region a protected zone. So it wouldn't affect, have any negative impact on Site 41 and the gradients. So the county chose to ignore that recommendation, the only one, because it had something to do with the approval of the gravel pit for my new neighbor, Sargent's. So I'm still working on this, and within 10 days I have to put my money where my mouth is, and I have to send them a check so I can get ready for the next OMB. But at this time I'm demanding mediation. The last time I asked for that, and they got around me, and by the time I got there, they said, well, it's too late. They don't want to mediate with me because I'll be able to actually, I won't be held up by some slick lawyer who says to me, what kind of game are you playing, Steve? I didn't know I was playing a game. I'm not playing a game, it's about our water. So if Sargent has this pit, they've already got 100 acres, why don't we let them mine that one for 50 years before we open up another one in our water? So I'm working on this. I hopefully have all this together. Just a thing called Millbrook and Dufferin and Site 41, and we're having problems trying to understand how much capacity is left in the county of Simcoe for our dumps. Stantec says 5 to 6 years, at least 3 days ago they said that.
Yeah.
But Rob McCullough, under oath, on August the 13th in Barrie, under questioning from Peter Rosenthal, agreed and said, yes, we have 10 to 20 years. Now, he said that under oath to a Superior Court judge. So obviously he has a different answer for different people. So we got to make sure we remind the county that their Director of Environmental Services has already told the Superior Court judge, we have 10 to 20 years. So this 5 to 6 years is something that somebody else is making up. And it gives us a lot more flexibility in deciding how we're going to handle our waste. So hopefully this information is useful to you. Thank you. Write to Scott Elliott and ask him, is he really our neighbor or what? Like, I mean, before we threaten him, I don't think we should threaten people until there's a need. But certainly, we have the power, and we just have to ask questions. What are the answers? Why does he need 200 acres when he hasn't started the first one? Well, the reason he needs that is because he's probably thinking in the future they'll never get them licensed, because this is what's happening out here. People are standing up, and they want to get this thing through. Ann's asked me to...
Waste management strategy,
which of course you'll know that there was three public meetings. A lot of people here attended. What's it all about? Well, it's a sham. Of course, we already know that. However, we're changing that. And the Wednesday night meeting, you know, I think broke the back of the Stantec presentation. And we need to keep this pressure on, because on March the 1st, the next waste strategy committee meeting will meet in the county at Midhurst, and they're going to discuss all the things that we've said. We've got to make sure they respond to all the things that we said, because if we're not there to hear it, the members of the committee, I mean, they really don't know. I mean, they have no idea. The fact is, they haven't got really any information other than what Stantec is going to tell them. So they have to be quick on their feet. They have to be able to jump, but they haven't really got the ammunition. So we need to be there to make sure we understand what they're saying so that we have a comeback. We have to be prepared to have the comeback. You know, you said we're going to have extensive public participation. So I said, well, what's extensive if there's no public meeting? So we got them to have three public meetings. We, the people, made that happen. That didn't happen because of, out of the goodness of their hearts. They were forced into it, and we have a new warden, and he's trying to demonstrate that he's listening. So we have a guy with a ear this big right now, and he's listening. And he has to respond to us. We don't have to be mad. We don't have to yell. We just got to smile and go, here, see me? I want you to do what we want. We're tired of doing what your administration wants. That's what we have to do. There certainly has become, like we all are well aware, there's a failure at the County of Simcoe in how it's run. The administration has way, way too much power. And the local, our politicians we send there, haven't got the information. And even they can't get that information. And that is a little stunning to imagine that the people we elect to represent can't get the information to answer our questions. So we need to, there's different words they can use, but we do need change. And so at the County of Simcoe, the very top is Mark Aiken. He's the CAO. And next to him is a fellow, I always forget his name, Rick Newlove. You know why I forget his name? Because he never talks. He's nowhere, but he signs every paper because he's Rob McCullough's boss. And Rob McCullough, he's the expert. He's the only one that knows anything that's going on because he's doing it. So his two bosses, they don't know what's going on. Rob knows what's going on. So we have to change this. And either they have to completely change who they are. They have to go from the, caterpillar to a butterfly. We got to get them to do that. Like, otherwise, they can't be there. You know, and we have to make sure our politicians recognize that we are totally disenchanted. We are just disgusted with how the county runs. And we can change it. And we are changing. You may not feel it or see it, but I see it. You know, we are changing how politics will be in the future of Simcoe County. And there's nothing that can stop it unless we sit down. That's the only thing that will stop the change that's coming. So hopefully you'll understand a bit more about this process that we're in. And yes, Don?